Hi, hello friends. Today's my topic is Six Sigma. Basically, Six Sigma consists of two types of projects. One is problem solving, another one is process standardization. Sigma is used to fix the major losses in the process, that is considered as a waste. What are the types of waste? You can list down. One waste is our over inventory, excessive work done for the minimal output. So these kind of waste can be identified through Six Sigma with a structured root cause analysis methodology. All the industries who want to produce defect free and eliminate all the waste in the process are implementing Six Sigma methodology. We need to focus on selection of the project. There are four categories. One is problem known and solution is unknown. Second category is problem is also known and solution is also known. And third category, we have a solution for the problem but we don't know the source of the problem. So fourth category, both can be solution is not known but we know the reason for this problem. So friends, like this there are four categories. Mainly for any given specific problem, we have to select where we don't know the source of the problem, at the same time we don't have any solution for that problem. So this comes under the top priority for the Six Sigma project selection. In order to start this project, this works under DMAC methodology. DMAC means define, measure, improve and control. So let us understand what is define phase. For any given problem, we need to structurally understand and define the problem in detail so that we can understand and go to the measurement analysis phase. So in order to define the problem, we have some specific tools like Pareto, cause and effect diagram and process mapping. All these tools are helpful to understand the type of problem and nature of the problem. We need to collect the data, or with the existing data also we can analyze this kind of problems through Six Sigma methodology. Please understand, to select any project, this total Six Sigma methodology works under data driven approach. So here data is the key decision making, not the experience or the position of a person. So here the main core team should have a process competency knowledge, as well as they should be expert of that process. So these are the main criteria to successful implementation of Six Sigma methodology in any given organization. Start the project, we need to make a cross-functional team who are all effectively involved in the particular process. They can contribute to the process parameters or knowledge of that process, so they can contribute very much. In define phase, we need to identify rejection or any parameter, whether it is measurable or not. If it is measurable, numerical, we need to quantify it and specify it. If it is not measurable, say yes or no, problem is coming, going, but we don't have a quantification. So S and no type problems are considered as a attribute type. This can be given as a yes for Y and N for no. For the data collection, we required 8 good data and 8 bad data. Bad data means where problem is keep on repeating. In this course, we can use many tools are there to identify whether identified problem reasons are valid or not valid. To go this accepted process parameters of that particular problem, there is any contribution towards the problem or not, that can be eliminated by using various measurement tools analysis of Six Sigma. For example, paired comparison, component search, any other tools are there that we can discuss in later part. So in order to understand this methodology, once we define the problem, we need to identify which tool to be selected. If parameters are identified and measurable all data is available, then in simple Excel we can start with paired comparison. So to start paired comparison, there is a structured methodology to evaluate whether that parameter corresponds contributing towards the problem or not. Basically, in paired comparison, the any given parameter, good, you can make it in a green color, and red, make it in a rejected or bad response parameter. If you put it in ascending order, the minimum parameter value and the maximum parameter value should not correspond to same value. Second criteria, after ascending, there is a clear cut demarcation, bad becomes good. You have to make a demarcation and start the counting. So each one parameter, each one bad reading or good reading, you can start counting. Like this, there is a clear cut methodology that can be followed and identified whether that parameter is contributing or not. Here in paired comparison, the any parameter which will count more than 6 is considered as a confirmed cause for the problem. The cause is confirmed, but it is whether it is controllable or not, or it has further reasons to that lead further and identified as a further why, that is small why. So for a given problem, we have suppose identified 10 parameters. We need to collect the 10 parameters, 8 good parameters, which good run data, and 8 bad run data. Bad means with respect to the problem. So in both we can analyze and identify out of 10, suppose 3 parameters are, we got count more than 6, those are all confirmed causes. Again, those 3 causes we need to funnel it further to identify the root cause. After measure and analysis, we need to confirm this root cause. Use Minitab as a software where we can readily available data can be fed and can be checked for the root cause analysis. Once the root cause is confirmed, in improvement phase we need to identify how we can control that parameter in order to avoid this problem. So once we fix the problem, we need to monitor that parameter for a given set of period. We need to monitor, and if results are positive, there is no repetition of the problem, still as a criteria we need to validate that parameter, again fixing up in the initial reading, then check the process response. If again problem comes, then that process is mainly contributing with that root cause. So friends, with this methodology we can pinpoint exactly root cause of the problem, then we can take a clear cut action on that root cause, we can eliminate that problem permanently. Analysis of the project should be handled by the black belt of Six Sigma trained people, and followed by the supported by green belt trained people. Below them there will be a few team members who can contribute, who can suggest. Or I hope this will give you brief introduction of Six Sigma. Thank you.